Ciao, I'm Marianne Esposito.
And I'm Father Jonathan DeFelice.
Today, we're making two wonderful Neapolitan treats, struffoli e cenci. That's it, real fast, real fast. Come on, get that baseball arm moving.
Oh. Okay.
Non c'è ketchup.
No.
Ah, già vedi, mi fa la foto.
Basta?
Sì. Sì.
Sono molto delicati.
Molto delicato. Grazie a lei.
Grazie, Marianne. Grazie a voi.
You know, my mother's favorite leftover sandwich. Come on, you're Italian. Isn't this beautiful? Look at how pretty this is. It's delicious.
How do you like that?
I think you're great. And now we're ready to do the twist. So, looks gorgeous, smells wonderful.
I use my hands.
I love this woman. Okay. St. Anselm College in Manchester, New Hampshire has a long tradition of academic excellence. Founded in 1889 by Benedictine monks, the students study not only the works of civilization's great men and women, but the people themselves. As president, Father Jonathan DeFelice helps guide over 2,000 students along the path toward their college degrees. It's a lot of work for him and the faculty and staff at St. Anselm, but the satisfaction they get makes all their efforts worthwhile. Whenever he has free time, Father Jonathan loves to cook for his fellow monks. And today, we're in the monastery kitchen, getting ready to make something truly divine for you. Okay, Father Jonathan, so you know, you and I, we both grew up with struffoli, right?
We did.
It's a popular Neapolitan dessert. We usually have it at
Christmas.
Christmas, holiday time.
Easter. Right.
And everybody makes theirs a little different because, you know, that's the way Italy is. There's
right.
nothing written down. It's all up here, right?
Right, exactly.
All right, so you're going to show me your version of struffoli.
Great. We're going to start. This is actually my grandmother Balzano's recipe, my mother's recipe that I got from her. And we start by mixing 6 eggs. Mm-hmm. And we need to save at least one of the shells because I'll explain that in just a moment.
Okay. And your grandmother Balzano was from where, Naples?
From Ottaviano, which is just on the other side of Mount Vesuvius, so mm-hmm. It is that Naples area.
Yeah.
And she was a marvelous cook, but didn't write down any recipes. So this recipe that I have is a little odd in that the measurements are in the half of an eggshell.
I love that.
So we have 6 eggs. We're going to take 6 half shells of oil. And I use corn oil, but you can use vegetable oil or light olive oil.
Yeah, olive oil would be good in that.
And somehow this always works, even though the eggs might vary in size, or the half of the shell might vary in size.
So you had 6 of those?
6 of the oil.
I would say probably about a half a cup total.
Just about.
Yeah.
And then we have 4 half shells of water.
Okay. Maybe a little more than a quarter of a cup, third of a cup,
probably.
Maybe?
That's probably about mm-hmm. right. And that's it. It's a very simple dough. Then we mix these together.
Mm-hmm. Now, how often do you, you may only make this at holiday, right? You
make this at holiday, right.
Yeah.
And special occasions. It was always something that was brought out for big occasions.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes at weddings. Actually, when I was ordained a priest, we had a sort of reception, like a wedding reception afterwards. And my mother and her sisters made trays of these
yes.
for people.
For everyone to take home.
Exactly.
Isn't that the way it works?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So now we've got the eggs mixed. We're going
yep.
to take about five cups of flour.
And you already measured that.
And I did measure that ahead of time. And then we make a little well. And you could do this right on the table if you're very courageous.
Mm-hmm, but you'd have to say 3 Hail Marys.
That's right, I would. And then we add the eggs to the flour.
So this is basically like you were making a pasta dough.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's very, very similar to a pasta dough. And then you just work the egg mixture in.
Now, I noticed you didn't use any sugar.
No sugar.
And you used no salt.
No salt.
Do you know where the word struffoli comes from?
That I don't know.
Well, you know, it actually comes from a Greek word. Struphulus, which means a little rounded body.
Ah.
So when we get to forming these, it'll make sense, right?
It will
Why
make sense.
Why they're called struphuli.
Exactly.